Mats, Madu, we are the children, we are the children of God. Come, 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 we change our world, we have what it takes to do it smart and make it smart. Welcome to our Smart Do. Welcome, Class Pfizer, for today's CRA lesson. I hope you're doing very well. Now, we are still looking at the Apostles' Creed. And remember we said that the Apostles' Creed, or we have been saying that the Apostles' Creed is the way in which Christians express their faith. We have looked at several truths that are found in the Apostles' Creed, and they tell us how Christians express their faith. Which are some of these truths that you have already looked at? And they will help us get today's one. Very good. I believe in God the Father. I believe in God the Father. Another belief you have looked at in the Apostles' Creed? Yes. Yes, I believe in Jesus Christ. I believe in Jesus Christ. Another belief you have looked at in the Apostles' Creed? Very good. Yes, I believe in the Holy Spirit. Now, today's a believer that you're going to look at, or another truth that you're going to look at, and is found in the Apostles' Creed, is I believe in everlasting life. Everlasting life. Now, what does it mean to have life? Life, what is a life? For example, for all of us now, we have life. That is what we can hear, we can see, we can walk. Now, to have life means to be living. To be living. Now, when people die, even in traditional African society, they believe in life after death. They believe in life after death. Even Christians believe in the same. Most communities, most religions believe in life after death. And they believe that people come back in different forms. But as Christians, one of the beliefs that you have is what you call everlasting life. Everlasting life. Now, what does everlasting life mean? Everlasting life means life without an end. Life without an end. And this one will come after the physical death. It comes after the physical death. That is your body. This body we have now is no longer living. And it will be brought back to life during the end times. Now, when you talk about everlasting life, how does it start? How do we get this everlasting life? Now, for us to receive this everlasting life, one, you must be a believer. You must be a believer. A believer of who? You must be a believer of Jesus Christ. You must be a believer of Jesus Christ. And you must accept Him. You must accept Him. Now, apart from that, you must believe that He came from heaven. He came from heaven. He came from heaven. And He was sent by God. He was sent by God. What was He sent to do? He was sent to come and die for our sins. So that whoever believes in Him, whoever believes in Him, shall receive everlasting life. Shall receive everlasting life. You will, the moment you die, the physical death, Jesus says that the physical death, when the body dies, it is only sleeping for a short while. It is like somebody who is asleep. And after the day of judgment comes, the body will rise and it shall and we shall receive another body. We shall rise and we shall receive another body, and that body shall be for one to live forever and ever without an end. So once Jesus died for our sins and we believe in him, we get what we call forgiveness. We get what we call forgiveness. And once you are forgiven now your sins, you are brought closer to God. Jesus brings us closer to God by forgiving us our sins. Now, when I talk about everlasting life, how does it begin? Even though we are talking that we shall receive it after death. Now, where does it begin? Everlasting life begins here on earth. It begins here on earth. Because for you to believe, you must be alive. And you can believe when you are living. You only believe when you are living. You cannot believe when you are dead. So, everlasting life begins here on earth. And continues in heaven. Continues in heaven with God the Father, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, and all those who are believers. Therefore, everlasting life or eternal life, life without an end, begins here on earth and continues in heaven. Now, the sign that one has received everlasting life is baptism. Baptism. So, for you to receive eternal life, you must accept to be baptized. You must accept to be baptized in the name of Jesus so that he can be your savior. Now, in the book of John, we have a verse that is there. In the book of John, that is the Gospel of John, chapter 6, verse 47. There's a verse that truly tells us what we should expect. Jesus tells his disciples, "I am telling you the truth. He who believes has eternal life. He who believes has eternal life." So therefore, we must believe. We must believe. Remember I said, I believe in everlasting life. So therefore, for you to receive everlasting life, you must believe that it was brought by Jesus Christ when he came to die for our sins. Therefore, let's call upon God all the time so that he can help us understand his word and believe in him more and more so that we can receive this gift of eternal life. Thank you very much. I hope we shall meet some other time. Goodbye.